Hi there. Today we are going to talk about physical pong, the status and how it's working now. So let's get started. Okay, before we are going to actually discuss what's changed, let's first try to start a game. The game is currently in its start position, as you can see, as everything is on the same line, and we are going to start the game now. There are, at your side there, a few buttons. One with the green light currently on, indicating start. And a button for the left for the puck and right for the player. So I have the same here, so I'm going to press start. And as you can see, everything is moving to the middle. Now it's warning me with the start button that it's going to start. And there we go. Everything is moving now. And because no one is there, it's dying there. And the game wasn't matching. So now we are going again. And that player is dead again. If someone is dead, it indicates it by blinking the keys. And I can move my puck over here with the keys I have in front. If someone is dead, it moves it back to the position in center, and from there it starts working in. So that's basically the status of the game. I'm going to turn it off for now so I can actually talk. So let's open the game, and I need to make a bit of space so we can see what the status is. First, before we open it, we of course need to remove those. That's simply just take them off. The great thing, everything is working by magnets. So there is nothing here at all. This is just a blank plate of wood, and that's it. Everything is in magnets, and in the bottom here, and there are two magnets, and the same is in here, and that's it, just it. So that's doing everything. So now let's remove the plate. And here is all electronics. Basically, what we have done in the last few weeks, I have redesigned a lot of the parts. These parts over here, these are where the player mounts to. Basically, they are just going on there and with the wooden plate between. As you can see again, here are magnets in there, and that's how everything mounts. This part just mounts on this part with a few screws, and that's it. I have done the same here in the middle. Here are again a few magnets, and that's it. Those parts are redesigned specifically for the physical pong. The same we have at the other side of the player too, and there is everything. And that's most of it done for hardware. There's a lot of done in software. We have here a Arduino with a RAMS 1.4 shield, basically used in every 3D printer, and that controls all mechanics. The board over here are a few simple, really simple things regarding controlling the buttons and things like that, and that's all. This is the power supply, just a normal 12 volt power supply, and that's controlling all hardware. My RAMS is actually broken, so I needed a USB port, and that's over here, but that's it. So yeah, the hardware is really simple and hasn't been changed much since last time. We can try and start it now. There is a power button over here, and what it's first going to do is going to basic position, and that's it. Now you can press the button over here, and it's going to start. It's warning us that it's going to start, and there we go. And now I'm dead at this side. It's going back to the center position. And that's it. So let's shut down for now. So basically the hardware is actually really simple. It are just four axes like a 3D printer, and that's it. It moves around basically the same. It uses a belt system here. It just starts on the motor and MS-17, and here it just mounts. As you can see between it, it's a bit hard to see. It's easier to see over here on the player, but basically the same on every part. It's just mounting there with a belt, and that just moves. That's it. So that's the status currently on Physical Pong. So what are we going to do in the upcoming weeks? I need to solve a few software bugs. Currently it needs to move to the sender and then, or to the start position and then go back to the sender. I want to fix that because it's really not needed. And I'm also going to add a scoreboard. And I actually made it already. It's over here. It are two 7-segment displays, and I'm going to program it with the Arduino to show the score. So it's going to go from 0 to 9, and that's basically it. And if it's more than 9, that's not going to be shown on here. So I'm probably, and again, this going to mount with a few magnets, as you can see in there. And that will just mount on top of the game display. And that's it, really simple, but I'm thinking it's going to be really nice. The segments are around 12 centimeters in height, so they are pretty big. So it's really nice addition to the game. So if you want to make one yourself, that's possible. I'm currently also working on instructions and everything you need, including a list of materials and a list of items you need to buy. And you can get all information on my website, physicalpong.com. All information is there to make your own. The only thing is, because it's costing me quite a lot of money to make one myself, is to receive everything, you need to pay 10 euros. The parts itself are open source, and everything is open source. Only the instructions and the list of material aren't. So if you want to use that, you will need to pay 10 euros. I hope you understand. It requires me a lot of time and a lot of money to make this. I'm around 500 euros in this project now, and you will be able to make it a lot cheaper, but because I needed a lot of more parts, I printed a lot of parts a lot of times, and that costs a lot of money as well. I think I spent around 4 kilos of filament now on this project. Well, the total parts is not that much actually. So yeah, I hope you understand that. In the coming weeks, I will be working on finishing up the 7-segment display. I already ordered a PCB, and I'm going to hope that's going to work. I already have a lot of parts for it. I just now finished the PCB. I might actually live stream if I have it on time next week to when I'm soldering everything. So you should watch for that. And I'm going to work on the software to finish it up. I will also try to paint it, but I need to find the right paint for it, but should be coming as well. And I will be working on the instructions. So thank you for watching, and hopefully see you next time. Bye for now.